cognitive psychologists suggest that we use mental representations to represent our knowledge, memories, or ideas in order to store and maintain our mental processes. Mental representation is defined as a structure in our mind, such as an idea or image, that stands for something else, such as an external object or things that we sense in our past or future. But whatever it is, it's not something in the present. These mental representations allow us to think about things that are abstract and have no physical existence. Earlier in this lesson, when we talked about language, we asked about love and passion. We can also include things such as truth or justice as abstract ideas that we can represent in our mind visually and verbally. So visual imagery involves visual representations created by the brain after the original stimulus is no longer present. Now, if you recall, the visual system is mostly located in the occipital lobes. One interesting thing to note is that while we're visualizing something, our brain is active in much of the same way as it is during visual perception. That is, visual imagery has similar brain activity to visual perception. In fact, because of this, if you imagine doing your very best at a task, it may actually help you improve in your performance. Sports psychologists are aware of this and use visualization techniques to help improve athletes' performance. Researchers have noted that both visual imagination and visual imagery are the most important to many creative accomplishments, both in science and in art.